from Yoon. This is just an introduction to tuberculosis. We'll just put tuberculosis 1 for the title. I use the acronym RIPE as in the induration, which shows a positive TB test looks like the skin is ripe. And I'm going to change that a little bit to RIPER, just so that we'll talk about another R that is very important. So the RIPE or RIPER acronym begins with rifampin, brand Rifidin, though worldwide I see rifampicin as the drug name. Isoniazid, which really comes generic only, the medical abbreviations INH. These words tend to get really long. The pyrazinamide, which is PZA. And then ethambutol, which is brand myambutol. So R, rifampin, I, isoniazid, P, pyrazinamide, E, ethambutol. But if you had a protease inhibitor substitution, you would use a protease inhibitor substitution for rifampin, which would be rifabutin, brand mycobutin, if the patient was HIV positive on a protease inhibitor. So practice question 1, we're not going to do the classes because they're all anti-tuberculars. Their mechanism of action isn't really as important in this. But generally, we use multiple medicines for TB treatment, except for latent TB, when a 9-month course of blank might be appropriate. Select all that apply. In this case, it would be isoniazid. It's really the staple of the 4 drugs that we would use initially for TB if it's an active TB. Practice question 2, let's make A correct. So the TB medication that can cause body fluids, including urine, to turn red-orange. That's rifampin. And just use the R for red as a way to remember it. And yeah, the saliva, the sweat, the tears can also become red-orange as well. Question 3, this TB medication is a metabolic inducer, making some medicines less effective. Just to remind you, a metabolic inducer is the opposite of a metabolic inhibitor. So a metabolic inhibitor stops or slows the metabolism of a drug. So when you slow the metabolism or the change into metabolites, then you get more of the drug around. An inducer will do the opposite, in which if you induce the metabolism, you actually speed it up, and whatever interaction it has, there's going to be less of it around. So rifampin has this interaction with warfarin, oral contraceptives, protease inhibitors. And what would that mean? That would mean that you have less warfarin. So instead of the patient bleeding, it would actually cause the patient to be anticoagulated, if that's a word, where they might have a stroke or they might have some kind of thrombotic event because the coagulation's not proper. The oral contraceptives, if you have less oral contraceptive, might result in pregnancy. And then the protease inhibitors, it would cause them to not work as well, and then that would allow the HIV to remain. So rifampin would be the one that causes this metabolic induction. This TB medication will be replaced by rifabutin in an HIV-positive patient on a protease inhibitor. Rifampin, again, because of that metabolic induction, we would replace it with rifabutin. It's related, but not quite the same. Question 5, this TB medication can cause peripheral neuropathy. Isoniazid, which is a staple, can cause peripheral neuropathy. It's a weakness that the nerves cause. So somebody buttoning a shirt might really struggle with it because they really can't feel that tactile sensation that they normally do. Think of the isoniazid's N for neuropathy to remember that. This TB medication, number 6, this TB medication may necessitate treatment with ibuprofen for joint pain. Side effect of pyrazinamide in almost half of patients that get it is something called polyarthralgia, so pain and so many from poly, and then arthralgia is joint pain, so many joint pain, so pain in many joints. And use pyrazinamides P to help you remember polyarthralgia. Okay. Question number 7. This TB medication may cause optic neuritis. So ethambutol is known for this. And you can take the E for eyes or the O from optic to remember optic neuritis from ethambutol. Question 8. Most first-line TB medications cause hepatotoxicity, which is the exception. Rifampin, isoniazid, and pyrazinamide, they all are hepatotoxic, all damage the liver. So when there are patients on all of these medicines, we really need to watch liver function tests. Where ethambutol, it doesn't have this hepatotoxicity as a side effect. It's the one exception. Question 9. In the first 2 months of TB treatment of an HIV negative patient, we expect which medications in the regimen? And we would actually expect all four, rifampin, isoniazid, pyrazinamide, and ethambutol for quad therapy. But, practice question 10, in the next 4 months of TB treatment, that kind of continuation phase of an HIV negative patient, we expect which medications in the regimen, and it would be rifampin and isoniazid.